everyone, it's Vicky, and this is a super duper exciting video because this is like a very almost nostalgic time for me. Hobonichi has been a part of my YouTube career for so many years now. It's just so exciting. Every time they come out with them, every year, seeing how many people have picked up a Hobonichi or a Fobonichi and put it in their lives is just beyond thrilling and so, so incredibly exciting. And this is my Hobonichi that I got for 2019. This is just kind of the package that it kind of comes in and what it looks like. In case you're unfamiliar, I know there's a fair bit of unboxings. So I'm gonna open up the paperwork here, or the bag that it comes in, and we're gonna take a look and see what's inside. Inside, we do have a beautiful orange box. It is for the 20th anniversary, which is awesome. Hobonichi, to me, first kind of crossed my mind in 2013. So it's amazing that it's been around for so long and has been loved for so long in Japan. And now to see kind of the rest of the world embracing and loving it is so exciting. It smells so good. There's so much good smelling stationery that's in there. This is a really pretty box. I don't save my boxes. It says Hobonichi Techo 2019. I might save this one just because I kind of like the orange color, and it is a 20th anniversary, just to kind of keep for storage. It'd be pretty enough, I think, to keep for storage. I haven't kept a lot in the past just because it takes up a lot of room. I do know there is a quote on here that everyone's been a fan of so far. Don't ever lose hope. It's far too important. You know how a pinch of salt changes the whole flavor of a dish. Your hope is that salt. Very great quote that they chose on there to get people inspired kind of for the new year. So I have a couple of clear covers in here that I will go through and share. And then kind of all the little goodies inside. We'll go through everything right now. So this is kind of a unique little thing. Hobonichi, I think, is very good at gifting something. Now, I haven't placed a Hobonichi order in actually a little while, even though I do have a Hobonichi this year. It's from Amazon. So it's been a little while since I've actually done from the actual Hobonichi site. So you get a little bear that's like a little weight, paperweight, I guess. It's supposed to be the not-so-scary bear. This is supposed to be the not-so-scary bear, even though it's like a bear holding a Hobonichi with fangs in his mouth. It's got a good amount of weight to it. It's a cute thing to pose as a prop, I think, for, you know, Instagram photos or anything like that. It's definitely unique. I think last year they got dice that would go with meal prepping. So this is kind of a unique little paperweight to get. I think, like I mentioned, it's great for any kind of Instagram kind of photos. That's how I would really kind of use it or pose it. Or, I mean, it's cute if you did keep it. So you can kind of hear how much weight it has. If you did need to keep, you know, page down or something like that, I guess it's cute for that. The pen this year, I think they nailed it with the colors. So you have a white body, and the tip here is kind of like a peach color, maybe blush, but I'm leaning more towards peach. And then the tip here is clear, so you can see the color that you are going with. So when we go with the red, you can see the red. When we go with the blue, you can see the blue and the black as well. So I really love these pens. I have all of the pens that I've ever gotten from Hobonichi, and I think that's only like three actually that I have. I have one that's all yellow, I have one that is like black, and then also kind of has like a peachy brown color here at the base as well. They're great pens. They work really, really nicely in the Hobonichi. They're a great addition, great kind of collector's item. People do love to kind of collect those as well. And then I have a little bag here of little goodies. I rarely get a ton of accessories from Hobonichi, but there were a couple that I didn't want to pass up this year. I love how everything smells. It has a great plasticky smell. So I went with this little stamp here, and it's very reminiscent to me of the Chronodex, but it's got the 24-hour, it's got a clock face on there. So if you're familiar with the Chronodex, the idea of it is kind of managing your time within 24 hours. So what I really liked about this, that it is a clock that you could potentially use to capture your 24 hours, because you do have, you know, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. So you can kind of get creative, I think, with how you want to manage time on there. I don't know. I didn't want to pass it up, though. I did really want to have that stamps. The stamps that they have are really very nice. It's not a heavy stamp, but it's a nice wooden block that's on there. So if you have that on your desk, it's a nice stamp, I think, to have. And then I got these, two of these. They're the same. I got two of them because I do have a Hobonichi Weeks and a Hobonichi Cousin, and I really liked the coordinating colors with the months to have like the tabs at the side. That's one thing that I kind of do miss with the Hobonichi is having the tabs. So I got two of them just so that I wouldn't feel like I was running out with them, but I do like how they coordinate with the Hobonichi. So I got those. I did pick up another Mega Weeks. I was kindly gifted a Mega Weeks from one of my patrons over on Patreon. She kindly gifted me one, and I've fallen in love with the Mega Weeks. This is another pen that you receive. The Mega Weeks, the big difference between the Weeks and the Mega Weeks is that the Mega Weeks has a bunch of blank sheets in the back for note taking, bullet journaling, whatever it is you like to take with you. And it's still a very compact, lightweight book. So I really love it for that. And it's just a great portable planner to have with you. It just works very nicely. I love the layout with the Hobonichi, and especially having all that extra paper in the back allows for a lot of note taking, a lot of kind of documenting as well. And so that's what I really, really love about the Mega Weeks. This is a denim cover. It feels really nice. It feels like a denim. I love the blue on there. So you can see this is like a more traditional probably Weeks. And they've added all this notepaper in the back. It is numbered, so you could use it as a bullet journal if you're someone who likes to bullet journal, but also have your weeks set up for you and your months, so you don't have to take the time to set that, all that up, but you can still kind of do your bullet journaling as well. Love that. Love the size of this. I'm a big fan of the Hobonichi Weeks, have been for a long time. This is like the little life book. They did a really cute job. I did see this in a couple of folks' unboxings. It's just a very cute, even if you don't know what it says, it's still very visually appealing and very cute. The pictures on here are just very, very adorable. Love that. I love that I get to kind of keep this with my planners. And then I went ahead and got another Cousin. I choose not to take the Avec route, mainly because I like having everything in one book. My Hobonichi is not that thick this year. I picked it up in March and have been using it ever since, and it is not super thick. The pictures that I choose to put in there are Xerox on Xerox paper, so they're relatively thin. I haven't put a lot of ephemera in there. It doesn't get super duper chunky, and I like the fact that the whole year is in one book. So when I put it on a shelf, it's all in one book. I know a lot of folks are fans of the Avec, but I personally just really love having the traditional all-in-one book. So I got that. And then as far as these clear covers go, I went with this, I forget if it's called Night Woods in the Nighttime or something of that. I'll have it linked below once I look it up when I'm done filming. But it has really pretty kind of gold-like flex on here, I guess, is the definitely not the right word, but there are little spots of gold that you will see within like kind of the creatures. You see some owls and some creatures kind of hanging out in the trees. I really loved how this is very simple, very beautiful, and I kind of want to try and adopt the clear covers on to the Hobonichi sometimes, even when I don't have a cover on cover. This year, Hobonichi decided to not give you a cover with your cover. There's a lot of times that the nylon covers came with a clear cover to put over it. They opted not to do that this year, which I think is a good idea because not everyone was using the clear covers. So now you kind of have the choice, and I see that they kind of upped their game in that regard. And then this clear cover is also kind of a nature-inspired one with the gold kind of sprinkled throughout. So the flower here has the gold. Hopefully you can kind of see that's there. I like the pink, that they put this on a pink background. And the covers are relatively inexpensive, the clear covers are, and I thought it would look pretty on the denim, and I still will put it inside of a cover. So I have a zip cover that I got from AliExpress that I will house this in, and then I have one more cover coming to me, and I still kind of think I want to keep a clear cover over it, more mainly for aesthetics or just to have something to swap things out. It's nice when you want to have a book for an entire year to have the options of swiping out covers. It's just kind of fun. I think for myself, it helps kind of keep me motivated and really excited to continue to use the book when it looks different or looks new. I had it in a cover, my 2018 Hobonichi, in a speckled fawns cover for a very long time, and just recently, a couple weeks ago, changed out the cover. So for this year, for 2019, I am thinking I'm going to be using my Le Cow cover that I received, and I do have a review for that. I think it would look beautiful in there. That doesn't mean it'll be housed in that forever, but I do really love the red that is on there, and I think I'm gonna be keeping it in there because it kind of is a little bit more of a traveler's notebook style. I wanted to get the clear cover just to even put the clear cover onto just the book. This book here, I know it's going to be larger because the covers are intended to go over a cover, so they're going to be a little bit larger, but I thought maybe I would play around and see how that would fit. I also have a couple of covers that I haven't used in past years, where I got a little overzealous and purchased them and haven't used them. So I didn't want to, again, get too crazy about the covers. There wasn't anything that I was willing to spend the money to get. I may change my mind as the year goes on. You know, obviously Instagram pictures start to influence, you know, my thoughts on how they looked on the website and then how they kind of look with when people start using them. So I can't promise that I won't get something, but as of right now, there wasn't anything there that I absolutely like was dying and could not live without. So I'm gonna see kind of as the year goes on. I'm really excited for 2019. I've been anticipating this order, and I was really excited. I ordered this on September 18th. It arrived today, which is September 25th. No, September 25th is today. Yeah. No, actually, I think I ordered it before that. Maybe September 16th or 15th. So about 10 days, give or take, that it took to get from Japan to here in the United States in Chicago. So that's not a long time, I don't think, especially since we're a ways away from 2019. I know we're planners, so we do want to plan forward some, but I think there is enough time if you are ordering. They're usually relatively quick with their orders. So this is super exciting for me, super nostalgic to be getting a Hobonichi order because I did not get one for a couple years there, but I'm really excited to be back in the Hobonichi game. Can't wait for 2019 and to start using everything that I have here. Keep up all your videos that you've been putting up about the unboxings. I can't get enough of those. I love watching Hobonichi unboxings. I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any questions or comments or anything, please always feel free to leave them below, and I will see you all again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.